off, Byron Jones.
And the return out shy of midfield to the 46-yard line.
Okay, partner, no surprise to you. I'm going to look at this from the defensive perspective. In the rain, you have to be more cautious trying to cover passing routes. Why? The offense knows where they're going with the football. The receiver knows the route he's going to run. You have to make sure you keep your footing underneath you.
Tua and the rest of the Dolphin offense heading back out.
So, Charles, there are the numbers. What's happened here? Defensive adjustments that's caused him to sort of fall off a bit?
I think so. That has to happen. You've got to make some changes because in the first half, they were pretty effective. But the second part is sometimes when you're doing really well, you get off your game a little bit. You get off the gas a little. You're like, okay, we've got this thing. And that's not necessarily the case. Maybe right now, someone just needs to tell a joke in the huddle, loosen things up, and get their big guy going again.
Juju Smith-Schuster, the intended receiver. Third down here.
And those two just haven't been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect them to have more completions to him in this game.
And that is incomplete.
Well, we saw that they had a lot of success last week throwing the football, but that hasn't translated to this week. But with his team behind, I don't expect him to back off. I expect him to keep firing.
And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line.
At their own 21-yard line.
Back out onto the field now comes the New Orleans offense. On first down, Timmons. A gain of three, second down.
The tackle made at the 24-yard line. A three-yard pickup brings up second and seven.
Here's a throw over the middle. It's taken in by his tight end. 7 yards on the play, and that's going to make it third down and less than a yard.
Brings up third and inches.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And this will wind up a Saints first down as the tackle made here at the 36.
Number 26.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. Third and two is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
Thursday night matchup. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. So from the 36 now, first and 10. And now a carry here for their fullback. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
He's brought down at the 39-yard line. It's a pickup of three. Brings up second and
off the play fake. He'll look to throw. Open man is Hill. He's got it. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line.
Josh Hill. It's a gain of seven.
Third and inches, and they've got some extra beef up front. Three tight ends. And a give this time to the tailback. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. Just a 1 yard pickup on the play, and it'll result in a fresh set of downs.
I think we're seeing the effect that runs like that are starting to have on this game. They're a little bit slower, that front seven, reacting to the football, almost like body blows in boxing, slowing them down, and they're really starting to take over in this game.
Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. They'll keep it on the ground. Timmons. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40.
the running back.
14 yards is the pickup. First down, New Orleans.
I think there's a fatigue factor that's kicking in defensively. You know the will is still strong, but I think the offense is starting to bend it just a little bit, don't you?
Yeah, absolutely. It's looked that way. We'll see if they can continue this already strong drive. So now first and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 39-yard line. Now here's a throw right side taken in by his tight end. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. A gain of 6 there on first.
Brings up second and 4.
Now an inside draw. This is their fullback. A 3-yard pickup on 2nd and 4. Now they'll need to convert here on 3rd and a little more than a yard.
A 3-yard gain.
And again, they'll go right back to their full backfield and goes backwards. 4th down now after a loss of 2.
I get the thought process. 3rd and short, give it to the fullback, let him bulldoze his way. But that means you're counting on your offensive line to win a lot of scrimmage, aren't you?
Yeah, and there was just a mass of bodies there at the line. Looked like more defenders than offensive guys. Winds up losing yardage. So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to make it a 2-score game. The kick by Joseph is good.
The kick.
And that will bump the lead up to 11.
Makes the score Saints 25, Dolphins 14.
So that's a big one. Obviously, Charles makes it a 2-score game. His 3rd field goal of the game, able to knock it through.
Yeah, not exactly free and clear yet, but as a defense, you get to play a little bit looser, don't you? Because you do now have a little bit of a margin of error, don't you?
Noah Igbinoghene on the return. The Dolphins take over 1st and 10.
The Dolphins about set to go to work on offense. And the complexion of this one has changed a fair amount. That last field goal made it a 2-score game, so they need to get points out of this drive relatively quickly. To end the Dolphins now with a 1st and 10 at their own 24. He'll set up to throw. And throw right side complete to Parker. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. Facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. 7 yards there and a 1st down.
That's good for a Miami Dolphin.
Two are going to throw. And he finds Howard complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. That one good for 13 at a Dolphin 1st down.
1st and 10 at the 48-yard line.
Again, they will throw it with Tagovailoa. It's complete to Parker, left side. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 12 more yards there and another 1st down.
All right, this is the time of the game where they're down a couple scores, and they've really got to get some yards in chunks, and they know the defense doesn't want to give those up, but they've got to find a way to take them anyway.
Now the question is, can they string a few of those together? 2 and now on 1st down. And he's taken down here by the Saints. Cameron Jordan, it's his 20th sack of the season as he continues what could be a record-setting campaign. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Yeah, and that's just so difficult for them because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's really a difficult task.
Now then, after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for 2nd and 23. Now Tua. Wide open receiver complete.
Tagovailoa.
It'll be a pickup of 15 as that'll lead to 3rd down. Well, that's always a good place to throw it just because he's one of the biggest targets not only on this team but in the National Football League.
And you and I both know the quarterbacks love these large body tight ends, and why not? Nowadays, they're really wide receivers who are just taller and have a little bit more weight. These guys catch the football, make big plays downfield. In the old days, we wanted them to block. Now coaches want them to catch the football first.
So the penalty yards marched off on the face mask. Here's first and 10. Kamara. And here he'll get it down to the 7. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice gain like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
Now they're staring at a 3rd and 8. That last play, backwards a yard.
There's no question that coming into this game, this defense was pretty vocal about his desire to take this running back out of his game, and all that pregame woofing has turned into results.
Eighth play of the drive forthcoming, and they need 8 yards on third down. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. His pass caught at the 4. And he'll get this down inside the 5 to the 4 before he's out of bounds. He did his best to just get 4 out of that, but not enough. And now fourth down. And Lutz puts this one through. And that'll make this an 8-point game.
The score is Saints 25, Dolphins 17.
All right, so they needed 2 scores to get back in the game. The field goal there, maybe not exactly what they wanted, but the necessary first step.
There's still time remaining, and there's enough time to get it done, preferably a takeaway.
First and 10 at their own 20.
Out onto the field comes New Orleans. Their lead back down to 1 score after the field goal a moment ago, so they'll be looking to string together a few first downs, likely on the ground as they begin first and 10. They'll try and start this drive in the air. He'll get this to his tight end, Troutman.
The pass.
It'll be a pickup of 10 yards, and that'll make it second and a foot or so.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
And he's going to be brought down here in the backfield. Carl Nassib. He's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9.
Well, they had the right down and the definite distance to take a shot downfield, but it didn't work out the way that they had envisioned.
No, that's a situation where if you take a sack close to the line of scrimmage, it's not that bad, but a loss like that, you can't take a sack there.
Yeah, absolutely. The one thing you cannot do, they did.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. And he locates Josh Hill, complete. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Give him 22 there on the third down conversion. With that grab, he now sits at 200 for his career, and maybe more importantly, a first down. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Harris has it over the middle.
The pass.
Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and it'll be second and very short.
10 yards on the pickup. It's second and
they'll try and run with their fullback.
44-yard line.
And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down.
I remember from my experience as a defender, when the big fella gets the football, you've got to get on him early before he gets a chance to get up ahead of steam, because once he does that, he's going to leave a lot of tacklers in his wake.
First down, he'll drop to throw it. Gets this one to Hill. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
Gain of 5, brings up second and 5. at the Dolphins' 18-yard line.
On the give, this is their fullback. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives them a first and goal.
Let's face it, you always want a team full of guys who can get you first downs and big plays of all styles, but you've got to have a big man. You can just turn and hand it to, and he can be dependable in picking up first downs.
So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. It'll be a gain of 5 there as they move closer. It's second and goal.
A gain of 5 brings up second and goal.
And this is caught. And that could seal it. It's a touchdown. Joseph on for the extra point. And the lead is up to 15 now. A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all. And it all culminates in a Saints touchdown. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. Taking it about the 1. And he returns this to the 22.
But not getting on the return. The Dolphins take over first and 10 at their own 22.
So Tua and the Dolphins down by 15. 1:54 on the clock. They need 2 touchdowns and at least 1 2-point conversion mixed in there as well. Setting to throw on first down is Tua. Caught left side, Williams. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
It's a gain of 5, brings up second
down. Tua sets up to pass it. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. 9 yards the pickup there, and it's a first down. Clock running, about to hit 90 seconds to go in the game. Throwing over the middle. It's incomplete. Devontae Parker, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down. Looked like he had a couple of different options as far as who to throw to on that play. And who am I to say this, but I'm not sure he made the right decision.
Well, the window of opportunity is always going to be small in the NFL. That's why those quarterbacks who make quick decisions and have quick releases have the most success in this league.
Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts, as he'll talk it over here before what'll be an important third down. Tua to throw again. He'll get this one underneath to Kamara. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40.
Alvin,
a Miami first down on the 14-yard pickup.
Miami Dolphin.
Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. He was trying to get it to his running back, Alvin Kamara. And now it's second down. Tua setting up shop to throw again. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete, so the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down.
Out routes are always timing routes, and if the timing's off just a little bit, it can really throw off a play. It looked like he led him a little too much there.
Yeah, there was a fraction of a second, because he caught it, just couldn't stay in bounds. Throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here. And the throw there going to be incomplete. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. They're going for it. Here's Tua with it. Open man, Smith-Schuster. It's complete.
That's good.
And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a first down.
Tagovailoa's pass.
The Dolphins going to take their second timeout as they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game.
At the Saints, 15.
That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. And the Dolphins are going to have a first and goal as he's taken down at about the 8-yard line. Now the Dolphins will use the last of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in the game. And again, it's Tagovailoa. To a hit, and the ball is out.
The pass.
Very fortunate to get another shot. Here's second and goal.
So this one, a victory here for New Orleans.
And they were really helped by their defense, forcing three turnovers.
I think what we saw in this one, today's defense. And what I mean by that is in the old days, pitching shutouts was big time. That was paramount. But the big thing was holding people down, holding down their yardage, right? Don't let them throw the ball through the air and gain a lot of... But now, it's about taking the ball away. Taking away possessions, getting the ball back for their offense. They had three takeaways in this one, and it led them to victory.
So for the Saints, the great run they've been on continues as they move to 9-1 now. And they'll get a few extra days to get ready for next week, where they take on the New York Jets. Meanwhile, for Miami, it's a loss that'll drop them back to 500 through 10 games. And they'll be on the road next week as they get a date with the Jaguars in Jacksonville. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Damn, Kane, you done kill Abel. Unbalanced land, trying to keep the people stable. The way I feel, I might it all up. The way you feel, you might do it for the buck. All black, born to be a rebel. After this, I might go and water down the devil. Listen to everything around me, I can't see. Picked a dozen roses and left them in Galilee rolling thunder. Don't hear my cry, don't let alibis pass you by violence.